to the E to the L to the U to the X. Hey there guys, Qwerty Afro here with another Train Simulator 2015 video. Today we're going to be looking at the newly just released, I don't know when I'll be uploading this video, but it's quite a recent release by JustTrains.net, the Mayflower Line, which is the Manningtree to Harwich upgrade or extension for the Great Eastern Main Line, the GEML, London to Ipswich for Train Simulator. I thought I'd have a look at it. I've been actually looking at its development for quite some time when they were releasing photos and stuff of it in development, so I'm very excited to actually have a play around with it and see what's what. And it also gives me the excuse to use the Armstrong Powerhouse Class 321, because you can use it in the scenarios that come with the Mayflower Line extension, as well as you can use the Armstrong Powerhouse Class 90, and there's the JustTrains 153, etc. So there is a lot of stuff that you can use, like with third-party DLC content, as well as actually the standard, you know, like the standard First Capital Connect 321, as well as the 360 Desario units as well. So there are, if you don't have any of the third-party DLCs, there are a lot of stuff that you can do anyway as standard. But if you want to use, if you want to use third party stuff like the 321, 153 from Just Trains, or the Class 90 from Armstrong Powerhouse, etc., then there are scenarios. There's quite a lot of scenarios. I think there's like 14 or 15 scenarios. There's quite a lot. So there's quite a lot of options to do. Shoutouts for this video go to the Two Geeks and Gamer Deluxe. That's again the Two Geeks and Gamer Deluxe. There. Links and stuff will be down below, and those are the shouts. So let's get involved. I think I'm just going to first, before I start, control shift E just to disable the DSD, because I really just, I despise it. Let's get into the cab. Let's get into this kind of camera position. I don't know why the HUD isn't on, but you know, it's nice that it loaded up without it, because it gave a nice kind of scenic look. So we have to, if I just look at my schedule here, we have to, actually there's no schedules or anything, because it just says leave, pick up. We're going to be going from Harwich Town to Manningtree, and then I do believe, so it's a good afternoon driver, collect passengers here, then depart for Manningtree, calling at Doverport, Harwich International, Rabness, and Mitsley. At Manningtree, take the train out of service and return to Colchester, ECS. Don't know what that stands for. I should know what it stands for, but I don't at this very moment. Don't know what it stands for. But so we're going to Manningtree, and then from Manningtree, we're doing a little extra bit where we actually shunt the unit into the into Colchester's depot area or whatever. So let's first of all, let's open the doors and stuff like that. Let's just go into that's not free camera. Let's go into free camera. Let's turn on the lights for the people and open the doors. Oh, I love it. I haven't actually done a Armstrong Powerhouse Class 321 video in quite a while. And we are in the actual Great Eastern livery, with the Great Eastern with National Express livery, as you can see the National Express logo there. So it's great to be driving this train again. It's a very good unit. It's probably one of my favorite units from Armstrong Powerhouse. Anyway, let's get in. Let's sort out some stuff. Let's get the AWS sorted. That is sorted. We're driving a forecast, so we don't have to change the reminder. We can take DRA off because we don't really need it. Headlights, I do believe, yes, those are on. We can go to the back quickly just to turn on the tail lights. And also, while we're here, we might as well just change the back one to wherever we go. We go to Manningtree, 5532, and enter. So that would just show nicely as Manningtree, and the tail lights will be on. And then if we head back to the front, we shall do that for the front view as well. So that's 5532, enter Manningtree there. That should be fine there. That is excellent. We're looking very, very good and very smart to go. Don't want to be too late, but I don't think there are any specific times that we have to abide with, because as you can see with the scheduling, there's not really much. It's just pick up passengers, and that's pretty much it. So I think that is pretty much it. All we have to do, we have to just put the, if we now get back into, I love this little screen here, just where you can disable things. So we are on driver operated, visual aids are off, so it's all good. And I think that is it. We just need to put the reverser in forward, and then all we have to do really is just close the doors. We've turned the lights on. There's nothing really much else to do in this cab, except I want to go outside and see the doors close. And it's interesting, we have three people here just observing the train as well, which is, you know, not weird at all. You guys keep doing what you're doing. So give the doors, the train's ready to depart. There we go. And off we go. We're not going to accelerate too much because we only have a 15 mile an hour limit for a bit. Good old 3-2-1 goodness. There we go. Get back in the cab now. So I've not actually played on this route yet. This is my first time, so just a little, give my opinions on it as well. It's a good little branch line to include. I should have done that horn pretty much ages ago before I went over that crossing. But anyway, stuff looks good. Obviously, we start here at Harwich Town, and it's a nice little branch line, as I've been reading up about. It's very nice so far, very detailed, like the gardens and stuff like that here, and all this kind of like bits of disused tract, it looks like. And we could actually go a little bit faster now because we're allowed to go up to 25, and then we have a nice little crossing there. Open up the windows, why not? There you go. Hear the train a little better. So, next station on the line. Yeah, I do believe these are, I think they are disused. They can be used, but obviously the only electrified one is on the left here, which we are driving on. So, it does look good, I have to say. So far, I'm liking it. Dover Court, we are now entering. Excellent. Oh, it's a very nice little station. Do we have any markers, or do I just go to the end? Not too sure. Okay, there's no markers. So I'm just going to assume I can go anywhere, really. This station is Dover Court. Oh, look at that. Nice bit of landscape there. I don't know what the river is here. Someone would probably say that's quite a big meander it's doing here. Ah, good old Great Eastern livery. It's not my favourite kind of livery. It's a very scruffy, in my opinion. Especially when like National Express took over and then they just slapped on a National Express logo on top of it. I hate when train operating companies do that. It's kind of a little bit lazy. But I understand, like, when you take over a train operating company, you take over a fleet of trains with the the prior livery or whatever. Obviously, initially you don't have the time to quickly go and fix up all the trains and repaint them and do them to the new livery, so obviously you just slap on a logo until you can do it. A bit similar to the Virgin Trains East Coast, they just slapped on a Virgin logo and eventually they all better get like, you know, that nice fancy full red coat or whatever. Anyway, all is good. Next station, Harwich International, which I do believe is the kind of ferry port and stuff like that. The ferry port to like to Norway, etc. Which is cool. So far I'm really, really liking this little branch line. I think it's a very cool little addition. It's actually not that expensive. It's I think it's about £10 on JustTrains, which is pretty good actually, and it does about like something about 19-20 miles of track. So between, you're basically between Harwich Town and you know, the Manningtree area. But it's cool. The scenarios that come with it are very good and very, and they stretch over quite a nice bit of like network. So you have, like, right now in this scenario we're doing to Manningtree and then to Colchester. There's other scenarios that you could Colchester, Harwich Town, and some maybe from Liverpool to Harwich or whatever. And then there's quite a bit to play around with here. So you definitely get quite a lot for £10 worth of content. You get basically a mega scenario pack as well as a cool little branch line addition to the Great Eastern main line, which is very nice. Anyway, I'm just gonna start engaging the break here because we are, we're entering this very, very busy looking ferry port, it looks like. And it looks like here you could possibly get like two trains either side, because even though there's like overgrown kind of stuff on the track there, it looks like you can get another like 3-2-1 on that side because of the overhead wiring, and there's probably going to be a double platform here. Yeah, that's quite cool. Oh, and do trains terminate? Oh, so probably trains do terminate here as well. There we go. Harwich International. Well, it would be a big station, wouldn't it? Because this is quite like a kind of a big kind of port here. This is one of like the biggest ports. Anyway, nicely slow down here. Very detailed station. There we go, nicely does it. A very big station, actually. So I'm assuming you can get very long trains on this platform. There are some class 90 scenarios, as I've said, so maybe some of them actually venture up until like this station or whatever. I'm not even sure in real life if class 90s go up to here to Harwich International. Probably maybe do, but they just look at the length of these platforms. And obviously you have the bay platform here, which is perfect for a class 90. Or maybe I'm just totally wrong and I'm just talking absolute crap. But to me, just looking, it just, I don't know, it looks like a very busy station. People will tell me in the comments down below. Anyway, let's stand clear of the doors. There's no point of, I just like ringing the bell, but there's no point of ringing the bell because obviously we are doing driver operation only. Right. The 3-2-1 does tend to have a very slow acceleration rate when it's just a four car unit, and that's something I noticed with quite a lot of other units of train, where if you split them up, they do tend to accelerate much, much slower as a four unit. Like the 3-1-9 accelerates much slower. There's loads of other ones and stuff like that, but that's also because these kind of EMUs before just had one motor in one car, in one carriage, while today's EMUs pretty much every wheel has a motor, so that's why it's improved the acceleration today, and then the acceleration times of today's kind of modern units, while these older units, it was just seen, yep, we'll just have, you know, passenger cars and then one car has the motor and stuff like that. One thing that's bad, however, with that on the DMU side is that DMUs these days, such as the Super Voyager, have diesel motors underneath each carriage, and it creates a lot of vibration and noise. And this is true on the class 180s, the Super Voyagers, the 220s, the 221s, and even the 222 Meridians. But it's a huge problem, and I definitely understand it, because when I've gone on to, like, I've been on mainly just the 222s on these Midland trains, and it's so noisy and it vibrates vigorously inside the cab. But then you have the older HSTs and stuff like that, which obviously because their engines and their units, their power units are at the front or back, the carriages are just, you know, rolling along some track, and you get, you know, no noise pretty much, unless you're near one of the power units. But in the middle, you basically have no noise whatsoever, and it's so nice. So it's a bit of a problem there, but obviously with DMUs like the Super Voyagers or the 180s, they accelerate much quicker because obviously they have, like, the thing with them, they have electric motors running the wheels, but the diesel engines should just supply the actual energy. So, you know what I mean. But, to be honest, I think HSTs accelerate pretty... Well, I don't know about all HSTs, but the HSTs that they use on Eastbourne trains, I thought they accelerate pretty fast for like, a HSD. I don't know if that's to do with they have the VP185 Valenta engines, the only kind of near close to the original Valenta engines you can get on the network these days. The rest are pretty much MTU German engines. But, you know what I mean. But while we're talking, we're just passing all this kind of nice views and stuff. It's definitely a very... I like these kind of nice little branch lines. And, you know, this is something I wish there was more of. I wish there was... And Dovetail Games do... one thing they do, which I like and sort of dislike, is that they add the possibilities of branch lines. But then sometimes they add them in and sometimes they don't. And then it leaves it leaves like other third-party developers, like how now JustTrains have made the Mayflower line, to kind of pick up the pieces and maybe add them as extensions or whatever. I really wish that maybe more was done in that kind of department. Like, I wish, like, the thing they did, like, one of the good things they did is when they released the Sheerness branch, Sheerness on Sea branch for the London to Faversham. I thought that was really cool. And even though, like, people would argue, oh yeah, but why should we pay, like, for just, like, a really short little branch line? It's a nice little branch line, and I enjoyed playing it, and I've got many hours out of it. And this, I'm sure I'm going to have two as well, because now I can use the this lovely train that I've only pretty much used on the rest of GML and their very, very long scenarios by Armstrong Powerhouse, and just to have this now to just play with as a little branch line is really, really nice. And what is that on top of this? What the hell? Oh, they're building a bridge or whatever. Anyway, we are soon going to be approaching our next station, which is Rabness. Have no idea. People will correct me for these bad pronunciations. Yeah, okay, we're not getting time, which is good. I like these kind of scenarios. Just nicely, just, you know, it doesn't matter what time you get there. You get there when you get there. You know what I mean. Right, start to engage a bit of brake. This platform, this station looks like it has very small platforms, so we cannot afford to miss or mess up. We can afford to underrun a bit, but overrun is we have no options to overrun. We just have to get it. But the brakes are very nice on this unit, so there's nothing really much to worry about. Oh, it's so good to be back in the 3-2-1. I haven't actually played it in quite a bit. I think last time I played it was on stream at some point. But it is a marvellous train. Nicely does it. Oh yeah, these are very small platforms. I'm going to have to get this bang on the mark. Nicely does it. Nicely does it. Oof. Oof. Not too bad, if I don't say so myself. And you can hear all the lovely birds chirping away. It's all good. Very nice little station. Just, like, you know, just a nice little road. I like these kind of small stations. You literally just walk from the entrance and then bam, you're there onto the train. I just like that. It's very nice. Right, we're almost ready to depart. Stand clear of the doors. Actually, I'm going to do it from this side. Oh no, I'll do it in the next station with this side. I like this kind of angle here. It's kind of nice. Stand clear. Girls, get out my way. There we we go. Off to Mitsley, which is our next station. Oh, it just looks really good. Oh, nice little downhill there section for it to speed up a bit. Also, there's a turning point here. Interesting. So I guess trains can turn back here if they need to. Hear the lovely gusping of the wind. It's all very, very nice. Now leave it to coast a bit now because we've gotten up to 60. Probably have to slow down a bit now because there's just loads of little downhill bits and uphill bits. This is pretty much going to... Yeah, there's quite a lot of... Yeah, little dips and slopes. But when this video is up, I'm probably going to be somewhere in Scotland. Well, not somewhere, but, you know, in Scotland. And who knows what I'll be getting up to. I hope the weather is going to be good. As I've been mentioning in previous videos, how, like, the weather, I hope, is decent and manageable. Like how it is in this game right now. If it was like this in this game right now, I'd be very, very happy. But I doubt it. It's been actually good. Over the past week or so, we've been getting some good high pressure systems in around the country, which is good, and it's resulted in some really, really nice weather. And they have been saying that June would be like sort of a heat wave or whatever. So that's good. If that can continue and reach up all the way to the tops of Scotland, I'm a happy bunny. This is such a pleasant little branch line, I have to say. It really is. And if you want any bit more information about it, the link down to the JustTrains.net store page for this Mayflower Line Manningtree to Harwich extension will be in the link. The link will be down below in the description. You can have a look. You can have a look at all the kind of scenarios that come with it. They break down what scenarios and what scenarios use what trains. And there's loads of scenarios that are just for default trains where you don't have to be getting the third-party DLC or whatever. And then they have a whole variety of third-party trains and DLCs and stuff like that that you can play if you have them. Which I have some. Like, I have most. But there's some, like, the JustTrains 153 I need to get if I want to play any more of them or whatever. So I'll definitely see. I definitely want to... And definitely get more JustTrains products. I don't have a lot, but I definitely want to, in the future, definitely invest into some JustTrains products and do some video content on them. Because they have some really nice stuff. And the thing is, I like how JustTrains and Armstrong Powerhouse work together really well. Like, you have, like, in the description for these scenarios and stuff that come with this extension, they actually, like, say, oh, you'll need this. If you want to have, like, this scenario, you'll need this, the Armstrong Powerhouse or whatever, and they give links to the Armstrong Powerhouse, like, products and stuff like that. So they didn't have to do that. Like, you can have a company that just makes, you know, scenarios and just uses default ones or their ones only, and it's nice that they're using, they're saying, look, you can use this one, because obviously this is probably, this train I'm driving right now is the kind of one of the best trains for the GEML. So it's definitely not a surprise why they were saying, oh, yep, we've made scenarios for this one. Well, this train isn't the main one, but, the, you know, the Class 90 is, and you have, you know, the 360s and this, and then you have, obviously, we want the, like, 315s, etc. in it. Anyway, we are now entering Mitsley. Mistly, however you pronounce it. And I think I'm going to slightly overrun here. Yes, I am. No, I'm not. Yes, I am. We're just going to ignore that. Oh, whoa. I kind of didn't judge that. I should have judged that like the previous station. I honestly thought this was slightly longer, but actually it wasn't. So it came in a little too fast. But hey, what can you do? Just move down along the carriage and get out from another carriage. That's what I would say if this was me in real life. Well, actually, if this was me in real life, I wouldn't have a job. But you know what I mean. Again, really nice little station here. Sankyazors, the next station is Manningtree, where this train terminates. Compressor kicking in there. And off she goes. Just lovely. Hopefully we won't do any more overruns like that. I think my policy should be, like, for videos, like, disclaimer, at least one underrun or overrun will happen during the video. So people know. They're just waiting. They're waiting to fill out their betting slips to see what station is it going to be, what train is it going to be, you know, how much is it going to be. But I think there we just went, like, about 3/4 of a carriage over, so, you know, it's about a smidge. Ah, so we're going into the bay platform of Manningtree, and then we terminate there, let off the passengers, and then we reverse into the reversing point. Oh, that's really nice. That's really, really nice. So, yeah, get to Manningtree, then stop at reversing point, and then we go to Colchester with an empty stock of train. Right, I need to start slowing down now. We don't want to overrun at a bay platform. I don't think you can really overrun at a bay platform without actually causing a bit of death. Ladies and gentlemen, this is your driver speaking. Let me just delight you. Let me start that again. Ladies and gentlemen, this is your driver speaking. We are now shortly approaching Manningtree, where this train terminates. Please be sure to have all your personal belongings with you when leaving the train. This train terminates here at Manningtree. Change here for alternating services on the Great Eastern Main Line to other destinations. Again, this is Manningtree, where this train service terminates. Thank you, and thank you for boarding National Express. Great Eastern, or whatever it's called. Is it National Express Great Eastern, or is it just National Express? Oh, a 360 unit. Nice. Lovely. Very nice. Ooh. I'm gonna do a nice shot here. Hopefully nothing will go wrong with me staying here. Even though I have a bad feeling about this. There we go. Oh, the flanging's good. And the back door doesn't open. That's just sad. I'm a bit sad about that. Oh well. Let's see how well I did. That felt close. Oh, that's not too bad. I was kind of reading off the little HUD that I was a bit too close, but that's actually all right. But technically, I should have gone a little. If I went a little forward, I probably the back doors would have opened. But that's a shame that the back doors didn't open. That's really just a shame. Driver, it is time to change ends and head to Colchester EC, yes, East Coast Sheds. Something I'm really sorry, I apologize. ECS. Once passenger unloading is complete, you have a proceed aspect. Wait, what? Once passenger unloading is complete and you have a proceed aspect, pull clear of signal CO196. Sure, will do. Let's just. I want to change this. Do we have one to depot? Or not? Not in service. It's just there's just an empty for depot. Yes, five. So clear that 5551. Enter empty to depot. Yes, I've always wanted to do that. Finally get to do it. So we get to turn off the there. We put on the tail lights, which hopefully will look like that. There we go, that looks nice. Then we turn off the reverser like that, and then we get to this side, and oh, perfect, we can just turn that one to empty to depot. There we go. And we don't need the DRA on because we don't have a red light. Reset the AWS there. Open a window because why not? And I think that is pretty much. Oh yeah, we have to turn off the tail lights, put the daylights on, and there we go. Empty to depot, ready to go. So we can go down here and just close the doors and say goodbye, guys. We're going. If I do Shift O, there we go. Yeah, and then that turns off the salon lights. So this is all really authentic, isn't it? Say close the doors. Trains ready to depart. Well, there's no one to tell that to, but you know what I mean. Right. Off we go. Shame there isn't a lot of AI. Maybe it's just... Well, it's the end of the day. It's about 6 p.m. in game time. There we go, a nice empty to depot stock. 3-2-1. Leaving. That's lovely. Now I'm going to have to change ends again. It's like I did all that nice setup for nothing. Because I'm going to have to change it again. And let's just... nicely slow down. There we go. And so, what does that involve? Change that there. Tail light on there. Off with the headlight. And then back here. Reset up AWS. Turn off headlight. And turn the headlight on again. There we go. Okay, driver, change ends. When you have the proceed aspect, you may depart for Colchester. Thank you. What does that... Oh, yeah, we do. Yeah, we're fine. We're good. Right. Shall we head off to the depot? And off we go. Nicely does it. I'm really enjoying the scenario. Really good, like, kind of thing. I like this kind of thing where you... drop off passengers, do your little shift, and then you just head back to depot. It's really nice, really, really authentic. And on to the main line we go. And if people are having problems finding where these scenarios are for this branch line, they are actually incorporated into the GEML scenario, so that, like, I was for myself even trying to find where it is for a bit of time when I loaded up for the first time. I was like, where the hell is it? It's with the GEML scenarios. And off we go. Time to stretch the 321's legs a little bit up to Colchester, which isn't about 7 and 3/4 miles. We are MT2 depot, that is very correct. Ooh, gonna hear the... open the taps up a bit now. Does take quite a bit of time to speed up in this train, as I said, it is a bit slow when it's in a four car configuration, but you know, what can you do? Well, we're cruising, so it's all good. I'll turn off the HUD, we don't really need it, we're just cruising here up to 100, which we probably will never get to, and then there's nothing really for another good 4, 5, 6 miles. Well, what do you guys think of this? I think it's a very nice little addition, and for £10, I think it's bang for buck. It's such good value. You get a cool extension line. You get 20 miles of track, which is really nice, really nicely in detailed. You get a lot of scenarios, and I mean a lot of scenarios. So you have quite a lot of variations of what you can do. And even if you don't have a lot of third-party DLC and stuff, you can still have the default stuff. And if you have a lot of third-party DLC stuff from Armstrong Powerhouse or Just Trains, then it's good for both parties. And I think that's really good. And for £10, that's really good. You're getting essentially, as I said, a big scenario pack. And also you're getting a kind of mini route, which is... it's all good in my books. Oh, we're really opening the taps up now. Close the window now a bit, it's getting a little gusty in here. Oh, 8-car freezer one there. Oh, reaching up to now 90, pushing up 90, so the girl's got some steam. Yeah, we're almost at 100, would you believe that? But we have about now 4.5 miles. We're about 4.5 miles, which is... we'll probably have to leave it to coast in a bit. It passes 95, I'll get it there a little bit. Okay, let it coast. Let's do some flyby shots. Lovely. Very nice. But tell me what you guys think in the comments down below. Are you going to pick it up? Are you going to get it? Are you excited for this route? I don't know if there's a huge crowd behind it. That made Just Trains made it. Because I always kind of think with these developers and stuff that when they make something, there's obviously going to be some sort of demand for it. They wouldn't make a certain route. Obviously, the whole goal with train sim, especially for British players. For the British player base, obviously, because Rail Simulator, Dofto Games are based in the UK, most of Armstrong Powerhouse and Just Trains are in the UK, and the whole kind of goal is to obviously complete the whole kind of British network, which would be just amazing at some point. Right, HUD needed to come on there so we can see what we have to do. But yeah, I feel sorry for abroad users, American users. And German, American and German users still get quite a lot of content, but other than that, other kind of users other countries around in Europe, other countries in different continents like Australia, Africa, whatever, South America, they probably won't get a lot of content and stuff like that. And it's sad, but the demand is there somewhere, but these developers obviously make it for the people closest to them, which is, for us, it's probably just, it's Britain. think I'm going to need to slow down quite a bit now because we're having a 30 mile an hour speed restriction coming up after a 90. It's like slow down to 90, but now to 30. And then to 5. Alright, coming up to Colchester now. The run empty to the depot. I probably should have put not in service more than empty to the depot, but you know what? I put empty to depot because why not? I should have put not in service, but hey. What can you do now? They're both pretty much the same kind of thing. Actually, no, they're not, but you know what I mean. Oh, so we're going up to this kind of platform one thing. Ah, okay. I really need to see if I can get a livery pack for the 360, like a branded version of the National Express kind of livery or whatever. There is some out there. I could stop here, it doesn't really matter where I stop. I think that should be it, really. Yep, stop at Colchester. I think that is... I think we've done a good one, guys. We bid adieu to the 3-2-1 for again. Hopefully we'll see it in a video sometime in the future. Who knows? But it's good to see the old girl again in the livery that... You know, not the best livery, but you know what I mean. It's different. I think the last time I did it in the... it was the National Express one again, but it was in the more modern one, the more modern livery. But hey! Ooh, it just kicked me out. Okay. I could have pressed the X myself. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed the scenario. The Mayflower Line, the Harwich Town to Manningtree branch is available now at JustTrains.net. I'm not endorsed by them or anything, I bought it myself, and I was like, I wanted to make a video of it, so, there you go, I kind of like it, it's very nice, and to me, it's just, I like it because it utilises more of the, like, you know, the 3-2-1 and other kind of Armstrong Powerhouse products, as well as their own Just Trains products, like the 153, so that's why I like it, and for the price, it's such good value, because you're getting something like 14-15 scenarios, and a nice little bit of route. So to me, that's a win-win situation there, and it's definitely for £10, it's really good, as well as the Just Trains kind of loyalty point system. It's very good if you've like collected it up, because if someone's like collected up £10 of that loyalty system, I have like around £3 or £4 right now, but if someone's collected £10, that's essentially a free route there for yourself. I don't know if that's how it works, but you know what I mean. It's still very good value. I definitely recommend it. The link will be down below if you want to go check out for more details on JustTrades.net for it. Other than that, the shoutouts go to the Two Geeks and GEML Deluxe. That's again the Two Geeks and GEML Deluxe. Their links will be down below. And I hope you guys have a lovely day. I'll see you in another video. Bye bye.